You probably never knew it, but all the videos on my YouTube channel were shot by this dead Samsung Galaxy S8. It's dead, but I'm grateful that you and I are here. Today, we are back. I'd like to show you what has been happening behind the scenes, all the developments that have happened around here. I've tried to convert a spare bedroom in our house into a YouTube studio and a home office for two functions. Number one, I wanted to create a space that was simplistic and minimalistic enough to not distract me when I'm engaged in my work. And two, I wanted to create an aesthetically pleasing space that can inspire me to create even more content for you guys. I hope you notice that this is still a work in progress. You don't need to have the kind of resources to procure everything at once, but you can get yourself one by one to a point where your space is usable and inspiring and beautiful. I'll try to link everything that I'll talk about in the description box down below, so be sure to check that out. So it all started by repainting the room, and thanks to Wifey for lending a hand on that. The room was a strange, dark, bluish, greenish color which didn't look that great to me, and also made the room quite dark, which is a bummer especially for video shooting. You really need a ton of light, and I really struggled with that, so I went with white. I love white because it's bright, which is good for working and shooting, and you can really not go wrong with it because it offers quite some good contrast to basically any color that you throw at it. So it's great for backgrounds, especially for these darker skin tones of ours. Now, there was a bed that was occupying the greater part of the real estate in this room, and that had to be broken down into its various parts, and it's now lying in pieces along a wall right over there. And we had these two mattresses which are now working quite well as sound isolation foam to help reduce the echo in what is now an empty room. Something else that will definitely be needed here that I hope to add in soon is a carpet, because these tiled floors are also experts in generating echoes. There was also a mirror right on this wall that we had to get out, but we still salvaged it, and a good chunk of it lies right here at the bottom of these shelves, waiting to be put back up. And hey, any of you friends who have a sense of design, please comment down below with suggestions on what you could do with a big mirror in such a space. Thanks in advance. Next, the table. You definitely need at least a desk and a chair to start out your home office. Because I'm not yet at the level of getting motorized standing desks and Herman Miller chairs, I've been having this table that I used in like the first house I lived in that didn't even have kitchen cabinets. So I used it both as a kitchen counter and storage because it had two whooping racks. I went ahead and sawed off the middle rack here because it made it impossible to sit at the table, and painted it white, both to fit into the vibe of the room, and because I don't understand why nearly all furniture around here has to be brown. It's such an eyesore, and that's how painting can really transform an old object. It now looks better and even a bit more expensive. For the chair, the same study chair that I've been using still stands for now, but it definitely needs an upgrade. Hopefully someday soon I'll get something more comfortable and ergonomic to sit at for extended periods of time. This one is now a cripple with some of its legs falling off, and I don't think any sort of surgery can salvage it. All the same, everything is a work in progress. We'll see how that goes. So the desk or table goes on this one side of the room. The broken down bed and mattresses go onto the opposite side, and the next side hosts this bunch of closets with a stack of shelves on one side, which I think can sometimes also make for a nice background. And so on the shelves, we've thrown in some items here that work more like props. On the upper shelf, we have this lion head portrait that I've had for quite some time now. Next, we have some books and a nifty little light that has this interesting behavior. Part of the proceeds of the broken mirror is here doubling this light because you know you kinda need two of these puppies. On the next shelf is basically some boxes, batteries and tiny stuff, plus this house light that wife and I brought in all the way from Dubai. If you know, you know. Now the side opposite the closets is this large, glorious window with my rather political orange curtains. This setup allows for maybe around 2 or 3 different backgrounds that I could use for filming. It's always much better to film diagonally in a small room, so I could go like this, with the door towards the background. Though I thoroughly dislike the brown door and I'm gonna have to do something about it somehow. Again, I don't know why doors are nearly always brown on this side of the planet. I could also film this way, with the window towards the background. Though, that means that I'll mostly have to draw the curtains because the background light from the window sometimes gives very stiff competition to what I use to light myself, which is never a great thing. And talking about lighting now, let me take you through all the gear in this tiny little YouTube studio. But wait, did I introduce myself? Okay, my name is Dickens and I make videos here on YouTube to share with you tips and ideas to improve yourself and to get the most out of your digital life. If you like that kind of stuff, why don't you leave a like down below? It helps YouTube know that this is not a crappy video so that it can share with other people like you and everyone will benefit. Thanks a lot. Oh, and while at it, if you're not already subscribed, let me officially welcome you to the family. Kindly subscribe and also click that notification bell so that you are the first to be notified when I upload a new video. Thank you and welcome aboard. Okay, back to the video. So what we have here is basically three things, lights, camera, and sound. For the lights, what we have here as the main key light is the Yongnuo YN600L, I hope that's how it's pronounced, which is basically a nice bright LED light panel. But to get that nice soft light, we are shooting it through this wide umbrella, and both the light and the umbrella get mounted onto this light stand. We have a small secondary light here on the smaller stand, which would be used for different purposes depending on the video. Either as a fill light to fill out the darker parts of myself, or like a hair light to sort of draw me out from the background, or even just to light the background in one way or another. Next, let's talk about this camera that you guys are seeing me through. This one was quite a big step for me, but I decided to just jump in with both feet. This is the Sony Alpha 6400. The lens I have on it is the Sigma 16mm f1.4. I could go on and on about this combo and what they can do, but in summary, let's just say that it is one of the best setups available for the kind of videos I do. Let me know if you guys are interested in a video about this setup and where I chose to go with it. On the mic stand here, I have a microphone that I've used for most of my videos and I think the sound quality is quite decent. It's called the Blue Yeti. It will actually go back to the desk where it belongs and it will be used mostly for voiceovers from now on because I now have this other little mic called the Boya MM1, which I think I'll use more on the stand because it can be connected directly to the camera, while the Blue Yeti is a USB microphone that is intended to be plugged into a computer. I don't seem to be able to get just one mic that is good for all scenarios. You see, I have a third microphone over here, which is a lavalier microphone for maybe when I can't stand close to the camera. Though again, a wireless one would be a better choice in that case. So that's where we're at for now. I know a lot of changes and updates are still coming to this space, but I'm grateful for where we are this far. And I know that there's still a long road ahead. Anyway, for now, let me wish you guys a good day. See you in the next one, and as always, no pressure.